Hello, what's up? Ali here, and on this video, we are going to show you how to format hard drive or external hard drive or USB flash drive to FAT32. So why is this important? Well, most consoles only reads hard drive on this format, especially PS2 and PS3. While it is actually simple to format hard drive on this format, but there will be some cases where you need a workaround to properly format them and be able to use them, since the partition of the hard drive is also important. And that is the reason why some hard drive, even on FAT32, cannot be recognized by the PS2 or PS3 or some other systems as well, because they have a wrong partition. And we have to change them for them to be recognized by our system. Though there are some formatter that also offers this feature, but most are not free. And on this video, we'll show you how to get the right format with the right partition completely free. And we are also going to use a USB flash drive as well as an external hard drive. Let us start with our external hard drive here. If we check the format by right-clicking on the drive, then clicking on Properties, we will see here that it is on FAT32. But if we go ahead and check this on our PS3 cannot detect our hard drive. We will know if our PS3 detects our hard drive if we see the USB icon here on the video, or on the music, or on the photos. But if you cannot see the USB icon here, means that we cannot use that hard drive or USB to our PS3. In that case, it's either it's formatted to a different format or it has a wrong partition. In our case, since it is already formatted to FAT32, it has a wrong partition. Because if we go ahead and check a different storage, our PS3 can detect the other USB device, because this USB device is formatted on FAT32 and is on a correct partition. Now going back on the PC, normally I would first format the hard drive using this FAT32 formatter, because this FAT32 formatter only detects a hard drive on MBR format. So if it is on a different format, if we format it to FAT32 using this formatter, and if this formatter detects the hard drive, automatically it is already on MBR partition. We will see here that our formatter can't even detect the external hard drive. That is because it has a wrong partition. So to change this hard drive partition, the easy way to do that is by using a formatter that has the feature of changing the partition of the hard drive. But most of these formatter doesn't come free. So if you want to do it free, we have to do it using the command prompt. Press the start button on your PC. Then type in CMD to enter command prompt. And here type in diskpart. Then enter. Then from here, let us type in list disk. Here you will see all of the hard drive that is connected to our PC. And the one that we have to change the partition is disk 1. So from here, let's go ahead and type in select disk 1. Now once it's selected, we have to format the hard drive first by typing clean. But before we do that, make sure that you have no important files or data on your hard drive, because cleaning the hard drive will reformat the hard drive and will remove all of its content. So if you are currently using your hard drive, make sure you properly back up all of your files first before you format your hard drive. And if you are ready to format the hard drive, just type in clean here. Press enter. Now we have successfully formatted the hard drive, and from here it is now ready to change the partition. And to do that, just type in convert MBR. So just a short recap, type in CMD on the start button, then select command prompt, then on the command prompt type in disk part, and a new window will pop up. Type in list disk to check all of the hard drive available, then select the disk you want to format. Then you have to clean it first. Then from there, you can go ahead and change the partition to MBR. So right now we have already changed its partition to MBR. So let us go ahead and run our formatter. Now you will see here, if we check the hard drive, our formatter can now locate or can now detect the hard drive. That means that this one is already on MBR. Now let's go ahead and format this hard drive. So just click on this part, then initialize, click on OK, then go ahead and click this one again, click on quick format, then start. You will see that you have successfully formatted the hard drive. By the way, to download this application, I have already left a link on our comment section, and just scroll down a little and click on this area to download that application. You don't have to install the application. All you have to do is download and run the application. Now let's go ahead and prepare this hard drive if we can use this on our PS3. Let's try copying an update on this hard drive and see if the PS3 can detect the update. Now let's go ahead and try to use this on our PS3. On our PS3, we can see the USB icon here. That means that our PS3 can detect this hard drive. Now if we go to the system update, update via system storage, our PS3 can detect the update data on the hard drive. That means that we can use this hard drive to install homebrew and update our PS3. So if you have an external hard drive that you have already formatted to FAT32 but you cannot use them on the PS3, so simply change their partition to MBR, format it to FAT32, and you will be able to use it on your PS3. And if you are going to ask why did we use a formatter to format a hard drive to FAT32 instead of using it on the command prompt, because basically we can also format our storage using command prompt. But the thing is, in command prompt, there is a limitation to format any storage to FAT32. If it reaches a certain size, you won't be able to use command prompt to format your storage to FAT32. So you will have to use a different formatter, and on that case, I strongly recommend to use the formatter that we have just showed to format your hard drive. If that formatter detects the hard drive, then automatically it is already on MBR. Now let's go ahead now and use a USB flash drive. Using a USB hard drive is a lot easier than using an external hard drive if you just want to install anything on your PS3. If your USB has a size of 32 gig and lower, you can simply right click on the drive, format, then choose FAT32. But if your USB has a size of 64 gig and higher, unfortunately you won't see the FAT32 as an option here on the format. So we'll have to use a different application to format our USB to FAT32 if it has a size of 64 gig and higher. Our FAT32 formatter, this does not work on USB thumb drive. In that case, we'll have to use a different application called the Rufus. To download this, I will just also leave a link on our description. Just open the link. Now simply scroll down and click here to download this application. And like our FAT32 formatter, you don't have to install this application. Just download the application and run the program. Here on the device, click here the drive that you want to format. Then here on the boot selection, click here non-bootable. Then here on the partition scheme, make sure you choose MBR. And once you have done everything correctly, just click on start and this will format your storage. Again, before you click on format or start, make sure that you don't have any important files on your USB thumb drive, because this will definitely wipe out your storage. So if you have anything important, just make sure you properly back them first before you format. And if you are preparing your hard drive to be used on the PS3, and you have done everything exactly correct, but still your PS3 cannot detect the hard drive, now there can be two possible reasons for this. First is the external hard drive. There are some external hard drive that cannot be detected directly by the PS3. You still have to use a USB hub for you to be able to use them. I have encountered several hard drives that I still have to use a USB hub to be able to use that external hard drive. And another possible issue is the enclosure, because there are some enclosure that is not usable on the PS3. I have also encountered a hard drive that has the right format, the right partition, everything was correct, but my PS3 could not detect the hard drive. So what I did was I just changed the enclosure and I was able to use it on the PS3. Alright, so that basically covers our topic. If ever you still encounter some issues or errors with your USB or external hard drive that we failed to discuss, please go ahead and share them on our comment section and I will definitely address them. And if there's anything you would like to add on our video, please go ahead and share them as well. And again, this is Ali. If you find this video helpful, please go ahead and like and subscribe, and I will definitely see you on our next video. Bye-bye.